YouTube, welcome back to the channel. I'm Pop Shavocado in person, and before we start this video, I want to say thank you for all the support that you guys gives us. It lets us know that you do enjoy our content. As you guys can see, we did a lot of renovating here at the headquarters. We were able to get a shelf to display our Funko Pops and showcase them for you. We have so many new exciting content coming out. Pay close attention to this upcoming Friday. We do have a funny happy birthday haul that we feel like you guys would enjoy. And to start this video, we have a haul of Funko Pops from a big, well-known Funko Pop store. So let's go ahead and start this review.
Shavocado family, this is Pippity, and I'm here at Fugitive Toys in California. I gotta say, this is the biggest pop store I've been to. Look at all this pops. This area is mostly Marvel and DC pops, and most of them are $10 each. They also have a bunch of pop keychains for $7 and 3 for $20. There's so many options at this store, from your Disney favorites, anime, cartoon, movies such as Star Wars, I saw a bunch of them, Harry Potter, TV series, sports, and they also have the bigger pops, the 6 inches, pop rides, and 10 inches. And at the back of the store, they have a lot of mystery minis. And the best part for me is their wall of grails. I seriously could not take my eyes off these walls. I've never seen so much grails and vaulted pops. They have different varieties such as Freddy Funkos, iconic movies, TV shows, and cartoon, some ad icons, horror characters, and NBA players. They also have some from Marvel and DC, and they have a few prototypes that are for sale. And my favorite part of the grails is this rack, because most of them are Disney grails. And who does not love Disney? Check out what pops I got. It's your turn, Pop Shavocado.
So you guys, this is by far one of the biggest hauls that we ever did on our YouTube channel. We had Pippity Shavocado, our camerawoman behind the scenes. She had visited California not too long ago, so she did make a pit stop to Fugitive Toys, one of the biggest Funko Pop stores to see Funko Pops. And how was it?
It was really fun, but I could only bring so much. I tried.
Yeah. So we have a heavy stack of Funko Pops to show you guys. As you guys can see, we have 2 bags worth of Funko Pops. This one's pretty big, but this one right here, we got some heavy Funko Pops in this video. So I'm gonna save this one last, and we can go ahead and start with this bag right here. Whew. So, personally, this is my favorite anime. I think the whole series is very inspirational. If you guys haven't watched it, I highly recommend it. And this Funko Pop is the main character of the anime, and that is number 932, Naruto. And you guys, look how awesome this particular Funko Pop is. As you guys can see, this is a specialty series, and it is a glow-in-the-dark Funko Pop. But what's so unique about this Funko Pop is that in the series, this was when Naruto achieved his fullest, highest potential as a ninja. So he did become a very powerful individual when this happened. I remember he was fighting in the ninja war to save all the ninjas. And this was such a cool scene in the series. Continue on with the anime. This is an old school anime. I remember watching this at, I think it was Adult Swim or Toonami at night, but this was a cool anime about angels and robots that they would fight each other. But this is number 744. The main character, Shinji. And wow, If you guys can see, this is Shinji. He is the main character of the series. I do have a collection starting for this particular anime. So far, I have Aver 1. It's 747. It's his suit that he fights in. And pretty much he helps save the world and protect the earth from invading forces. So this is number 744, Shinji. Continue on with the Funko Pops. You know, this is a Disney classic. This is everyone's favorite elephant. I'm pretty sure you guys already know who it is.
It's my favorite.
Yeah? This is number 50, Dumbo. And you guys, wow, look at the classic design of Dumbo. I think Dumbo is such a fun character. If you guys haven't watched the movie, I highly recommend it. There's so many pieces in the Disney series that we want to collect. I think for right now, we are going to try to complete all the Dumbos. We might have another video on Dumbo exclusively, so stay in tune for that. And this is number 15, number 50, Dumbo. Man, it's a cool pop, right? Firstly, this Funko Pop right here is such an icon for ad icons. I think he's like by far the most prized or most favorite ad icon for Funko Pop. This is number 121, Tony the Tigre, guys. And look, this is a Funko store exclusive. And as you guys can see, this is a retro design of the original Tony the Tiger. And I'm not too sure if you guys could see it, but he is more round in this particular Funko Pop compared to the original, or I think the one that everyone's used to. What was your favorite cereal growing up as a kid?
Cocoa Crunch.
Cocoa Crunch? I have to say it's either Frosted Flakes or the Oreos. I think those are good too.
Well, we only had Cocoa Crunch back home, so.
Yeah. So this is number 121, Tony the Tigre. So for the next Funko Pop, he is also one of our favorite characters in Disney. Besides Dumbo, we are also trying to get all the Funko Pops for this particular character. If you watch our previous videos, he was one of our Grails, which we truly enjoyed having. And this is number 35, the infamous Cheshire Cat. And you guys, look how fun this particular Funko Pop is. So this is a Hot Topic exclusive. And what makes this particular Funko Pop so cool and so unique is that in the movie, in Alice in Wonderland, Cheshire is known for disappearing. And what better way to show that or showcase it with this half-invisible Cheshire Cat. So as you guys can see, Cheshire's upper body is visible, but his belly and below is invisible, which I think is so unique. Man, I can't believe you were able to find this Funko Pop there.
So, there was one on the shelf.
Yeah. And you guys, what an awesome piece. I don't know too much of this particular anime. I know a lot of you guys or a lot of collectors in the Funko Pop community enjoy collecting My Hero Academia Pops. But we were able to pick up this awesome pop. I just think the design of the box and the character was so unique that we had to get him. And this is number 248. All Might. And wow. So what makes this pop so unique is that this is a Funimation's exclusive. As you guys can see, this is the NYCC 2019 exclusive. And what makes this Funko Pop so cool is that, as you guys can see, All Might is in chrome, which I think is such a unique touch. He's like so super shiny, which I think is so cool. And the box itself, if you guys can really see, it's a matte finish, but the gold accents are highlighted, so it makes the box stand out, which made a tremendous like design. Like it emphasizes the whole character of the Funko Pop. And this is number 248. Oh my. So for the next two Funko Pops, we have to go old school. These are some vaulted Funko Pops. They are particular in the Batman series, so I can't wait to show them to you guys. This is number 3. Batgirl. And man, this was a tremendous find. So for this particular Funko Pop, it was made in 2013. So for 8 years, I gotta say this box and pop was kept in well good condition. This is part of the series 1 of DC Universe. I just like the whole retro design of Funko when they originally came out. I think it's so cool. And this is on Batgirl. Continuing on with the Batman series, this is Batman's trusty sidekick, number 2, the vaulted original Robin. And man, also with Batgirl, this Funko Pop was made back in 2013. It was part of the series 1. And for the age of this pop, this was kept in really good condition. And I just like the design of Robin. I think that's pretty cool. And for the final Funko Pop of this particular bag, he is part of a very scary or horror series. Personally, I'm afraid of clowns. I don't like watching or seeing clowns. I remember when I was a kid watching It, that traumatized me. And just seeing this Funko Pop just gives me the quivers. But here's part of the American Horror Story series. And this is on number 243. Twisty. And man, you guys, look at the design of this particular Funko Pop. He is one scary clown. So as you can see, this does come with the 2015 Comic-Con Funko exclusive. I would not want to bump into Twisty in the middle of the night. I think that would be a heart attack waiting to happen. And I think this is such a fun little Funko Pop for you horror collectors. And I think Fisher was one of the best counterparts to American Horror Story, so I might have to watch that particular series. So this does complete my review of the first bag of our haul. So we're on to our second bag. I know in the beginning of the video I had said I'm gonna save this last. This particular bag does have a Funko Grail that we're happy to have in the collection, and we can't wait to show you what it is. I remember Pivy has shown me a picture of all the Grails there. After seeing it was part of it, I knew we had to get it. I want to go ahead and take a moment of silence. This particular person was such a game changer for the NBA. He had helped many people throughout the industry. He was such an iconic figure, by far one of the best basketball players to ever play in the league. It's sad to see him go. I wasn't the biggest fan at the beginning because he always beat my Rockets, but I respected the fact that he was very hardworking and a great mentor for many basketball players, which made me like him even more. This is on number 24, one of the best players in the league and the best point guard that the Lakers had ever had, and that is on Kobe Bryant. And man, having this Funko Pop in person is amazing. Having a memorabilia token of Kobe is so cool, especially a Funko Pop. I knew seeing him on the display, we had to take him home with us. For those who don't know, Kobe does have four variants. This is one of the three. This is one of the four. The other three, the first one is on his number 8 jersey. For those who don't know, when Kobe first started the NBA or when he was a rookie, he wore number 8. The other Funko Pop would be number 11, but with also the same uniform. But towards the end of Kobe's career, he wanted to do a transformation. I know at the time, you know, he was getting a lot of bad credit or a lot of bad publicity, which he wanted to change his whole persona in the NBA. So he changed his number from number 8 to 24. And for the 24, it was the same box, number 11, but it was 24 in the yellow and purple colorway. So it's pretty cool that we have Kobe in his original uniform, but what's a bonus was that it also has 24, his final number. So it's cool to have a Funko Pop to display those two characteristics. I hope you guys enjoyed that little fact about Kobe. And here at Pop Shavocado, we're happy to have this Funko Pop, but not only do we have Kobe, we have to do it again. We have to get a second one in the collection. And this is such an awesome find that it's hard to find this particular Kobe, more of the fact that it does have both of his jersey numbers. So I think this is such an awesome find. So I hope you guys enjoy our haul of Fugitive Toys. I had so much fun doing it. I hope you guys enjoy watching this video. I ask you to please like this video. This does allow us to grow as a channel. It shares our content with other creators. If you aren't already following us on Instagram and Facebook, we pretty much post our Funko adventures and collections there. Until next time, I'm Pop Shavocado, and I'll see you guys later.